Chapter 6 Tested by Maya Devi Herself. Describing the transcendental personality of Srila Haridas Thakur, Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writes in his Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Antalila 3.227-228. Ar alaukik ek charitra tahar jahar shravane loke haye chamatkar tark na kariha तार्क अगोचर तार रीति विश्वास करिया शून करिया प्रतीति. I will now describe an extraordinary incident from the life of Srila Haridas Thakur, which leaves all who hear it astonished. Please do not put forth any arguments, because the glories of Srila Haridas Thakur's bhakti are beyond the realm of debate. Therefore, O bhaktas, please hear them with complete faith. One day Srila Haridas Thakur was sitting in his cave and loudly chanting Harinam, overwhelmed with great ecstasy. It was an exceptionally beautiful night, and the rays of the moon illuminated the 10 directions. The waves of the Ganga shimmered with reflected moonlight. At the cave's entrance, a tulsi plant sat atop a platform smeared with cow dung. The cave's beauty was such that it spontaneously attracted the mind of whoever saw it. At that time, a supremely beautiful and enchanting woman appeared in the courtyard. Her radiant limbs illuminated the surroundings still more. The fragrance emanating from her body perfumed the 10 directions, and she was decorated with many varieties of jeweled ornaments. The sweet tinkling of her ornaments charmed the ears. That woman of bewitching beauty proceeded slowly. She first offered her obeisances to Tulasi, circumambulated her, and then approached the cave's entrance. Folding her hands, Maya Devi offered her respects to the feet of Sri Haridas Thakur. And while standing at the cave's entrance, she spoke in a voice so sweet that it put the melodious sound of the veena to shame. O Haridas, you are a friend of the entire world, extremely attractive and possessed of supremely virtuous qualities. Enchanted by your beauty and qualities, I have come here hoping to unite with you. Please be merciful to me and fulfill my desire, for it is the nature of saintly person to be kind to those in need. So as to arouse lust in the mind of Srila Haridas Thakur, she then made various flirtatious gestures that would agitate the mind of even great sages. But Srila Haridas Thakur's mind was sober and unwavering. He only felt pity for her. His firm faith in Nam Sankirtan Yajna. With extremely sweet words, Srila Haridas Thakur said, I considered my chanting of a fixed number of rounds to be a Mahayajna, a monumental act of worship that I have vowed to complete every single day. I do not involve myself with anything else until I have finished this fixed number of rounds. This is my strict vow to complete every single day. As I have yet to complete my rounds for today, kindly sit near the entrance and hear the chanting of Harinam. I will certainly fulfill your desire as soon as I have finished. Having spoken thus, Srila Haridas Thakur chanted loudly while the woman sat near the entrance listening. In this way, the whole night passed. At daybreak, the woman stood up and left. In this way, she approached Srila Haridas Thakur for 3 continuous days, making flirtatious gestures that could captivate even the mind of Brahma. But they had no effect on Srila Haridas Thakur, who was completely absorbed in chanting Sri Krishna Nam. All the postures that the enchantress exhibited before Srila Haridas Thakur proved to be as futile as crying alone in the wilderness. Just as someone's cries in the wilderness go unheard by others, the provocative gestures and mannerisms that the woman assumed had no effect on Srila Haridas Thakur. On the third day, as night was coming to an end, she spoke to Shilaidas Thakur. O great soul, for the last 3 days you have promised to fulfill my desire upon completing your chanting. However, even after chanting throughout the entire day and night, you have yet to finish your fixed number of rounds. Shilaidas Thakur replied, What can I do? How can I break my vow? Hearing Shilaidas Thakur's words, the beautiful woman offered her prostrated obeisance to him and said, O Prabhu, I am none other than Maya Devi, the illusory energy of the Lord. I came here just to test you. I, who am powerful enough to captivate the minds of all living beings, including Brahma, today accept my defeat by you. I was unable to arouse even a trace of lust in your mind. You are certainly a Mahabhagavat, a most exalted devotee. By seeing you and hearing the chanting of Sri Krishna's names from your lotus mouth, my heart has been purified. I have also developed a desire to chant Harinam. Therefore, out of your compassion, please make my life successful by initiating me into the chanting of the holy name. With great eagerness, Maya Devi spoke, Chaitanya avatare vahe prem amrit banya sabhi jeev prem bhase prithvi haile dhanya ei vanyay je na bhase se jeev char koti kalp tabe tar nahi kanistar. Shri Chaitanya Chaitamrita Antalila 3.252 and 253. The advent of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has brought a flood of nectarine divine love, Prema Amrit, in which all living entities are floating. The whole world has thus become blessed. The birth of one who does not drench himself in this flood of nectarine Krishna Prema is useless. They cannot be delivered even after millions of kalpas. Some time ago, I was initiated into the chanting of Ram Nam by Lord Shiva, but by your association, I have developed greed to chant Krishna Nam. The holy name of Ram is known as Tarak Brahm, or the sound vibration that enables one to cross over Maya. It appears just to liberate the conditioned souls. This means that by chanting Ram Nam, conditioned souls attain liberation. Shri Krishna Nam, however, is not satisfied by bestowing liberation alone and therefore also bless a person by granting him prema. Therefore, kindly bless me by bestowing upon me the holy names of Shri Krishna. Then I also may be carried away by this flood of ambrosial prema. Having spoken these words, Maya Devi began glorifying Srila Haridas Thakur. Maya Devi receives initiation. The ocean of mercy, Srila Haridas Thakur instructed Maya Devi on Krishna Nam. Maya Devi, who bewilders the entire universe, was utterly defeated by this venerable Vaishnav. As a piece of iron is transformed into gold by contacting a touchstone, Maya Devi gave all the material desires by dint of her association with a pure devotee. She then left, happily chanting the all auspicious holy names of Sri Krishna. If a person chants the holy names of Sri Krishna incessantly, without offense or duplicity, it is impossible for anyone to shake him from this most auspicious path of Hari Bhakti by offering any worldly temptation. Even Maya Devi herself cannot degrade such souls. Srila Haridas Thakur is the best example of this fact. Pure devotees are eternally the objects of Krishna's pleasure, Krishna Bhogye. They are never bewildered by the illusory energy. Maya is not an enjoyer, Bhokta. In Bhagavad Gita 7.14, Sri Krishna has referred to Maya as Mam Maya. This means that Maya is the object of Krishna's enjoyment and it is Krishna alone who is the enjoyer. One who takes exclusive shelter at the lotus feet of Bhagwan crosses over Maya. Both Vishnu and the Vaishnavas are beyond the influence of Maya. Srila Haridas Thakur appeared in this material world and demonstrated by his own example that when a person utilizes all his senses in Krishna consciousness, then despite her best efforts, Maya's attempts to delude that living entity are as ineffective as throwing a pebble at the Himalayan mountains in an attempt to level them. Srila Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami has mentioned at the end of this narration in Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, most people think that Maya Devi could never have taken Harinam initiation from Srila Haridas Thakur. Yet I will tell you why you should have faith in this. Upon hearing this reason, everyone will surely believe that my narration is true. At the time of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's advent, personalities like Brahma, Shiva, and the four Kumaras, being greedy for Krishna Prem, descended to this earth. Having received the holy name of Sri Krishna, they danced and became drenched in the flood of Prema. Devotees like Sri Narad, Sri Prahlad and Sri Lakshmi came down to earth in human forms to attain Krishna Prem, and they relished that Prem. Even Brajendra Nandan Sri Krishna himself, in the form of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, descended to taste this great Prema. What therefore is surprising about Maya Devi, who is just a shadow of his potency begging for this love? There is nothing astonishing about this, because without the mercy of great souls, Mahat Purushas, no one can attain this Prema.